Allied Health in Assisi Hospice comprises of physiotherapists, occupational therapists, music therapists and art therapists. But we also have a team of therapy assistants who support our work. Different members of the team have a different kind of rapport with patients. So it could be that I go in first, patient really doesn't want to see me, really doesn't want to do anything, but a music or art therapist goes in there with a different approach and it works for the patient. And you find that later on, the patient is perhaps more open and receptive to me coming in to really do some work with them as well. So we really rely on each other.
Physiotherapy is a profession in which it works a lot with the physical movements of the body in terms of what the person is able to achieve or do with their current situation, how we can get them to stand, how to walk, or how to even sit better. It's to also help them to achieve a higher level of independence so that they will also achieve a better quality of life. Something that we often have to work with is patients' deterioration. When patients get worse, we need to learn how to manage in terms of their patient's expectations, also at the same time the caregiver expectations. I think it's important to find a balance between both. As the patient deteriorates eventually, it's also to pace with them and to remind them it's okay as they get worse. It doesn't mean that we can no longer work with them anymore, but instead it is to reframe their goals in mind and take into account what is important to the person at this point of time. Most of the time, physiotherapists are very afraid to work in palliative care because we are very used to setting high-level goals. But what I find more rewarding is being able to work and pace with the person that I'm working with. It's okay if they deteriorate, it's okay if they can't be as good as what they used to be. It's looking at what you have and working with what you have to keep it there as long as possible. Remembering that the person is a person in the end, it's not a person who is defined by their disease, but a person who is defined by their personality, making a difference to the person's life, even at the point when most people were given up, and being there for the person all the way to the end. And I think that's what I find, that actually physiotherapy in palliative care is very rewarding.
So occupation is a very huge work that comprises of three main components. The first thing will be their day-to-day activities such as showering, toileting, grooming. And then the next aspect will be looking at work. So work can be actual work itself, or if let's say a patient is a housewife, that is a work to them as well. And that is an occupation. And last but not least is basically leisure activities. My role at daycare basically is to help to optimize their ability in participating in these activities.
People always imagine that, oh, if I have a terminal illness, then I'm going to lie in bed and wait for my time to come. But it's not like that at all. In fact, so much happens before that really takes place. So I think what occupational therapy offers is life.
I find myself having to sit down with them for quite a couple of sessions to really understand them, and that's when you start to receive information about what exactly they are actually keen to do. Sometimes they still really can't, and you just have to give them an option, because it is that option that allows them to have that autonomy, that decision-making process which is so important to them. They themselves are telling me, I want to go this, I want to go that, and that's when I let my team know, look, these are the patients' wish list. Let's go and dig out from, see whether these places are feasible. These are something that family members may or may not be able to actually facilitate, because some patients are limited by mobility, some patients are limited by having O2 support. So that's where me as an occupational therapist analyze the activities itself to actually see what is actually feasible for our patients. And when you actually fulfill something that they would like, that's when they start to talk to you more of their needs. I feel that I'm really in the right line because it's very meaningful to me as well. I mean, I hope that I'm someone that plays an important role in their life.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Today we'll be doing abstract painting. 我们现在开始一起动手制作这个油画。
So we basically use art as a form of tool to help people communicate themselves, because sometimes you can't use words to say everything, especially with when you're faced with intense situation like losses and you have loved one who's dying. some emotions you just can't find words, so that is when non-verbal communication methods like art making comes in really handy. When you look at a piece of work that an individual does, you are actually looking at who he or she is on the inside. That itself is quite powerful, especially in a medical setting where everything else might feel very foreign. Sometimes it could be just 5-10 minutes of art making, but within that 5-10 minutes of art making, stories come out. When they make something, we respect everything that is being portrayed in the work. Everything that is being put into the work, we link that back to the individual, their personhood. And then we will talk to them about themselves through the artwork. We believe that everything that needs to be said is in the work, and everything that is left out is also as important as what is being included. Through art making, we witness acts of love, where you see family members supporting each other, you see patients requesting for family members to join them in the art making. For us to witness the art making process, the whole family come together, it's very profound. It's actually a very humbling experience. Every patient, they are the best teachers. I learn something about them, I learn something about myself. There's this constant growth.
Love me tender, love me sweet, never let me go.
Music plays a big part in most of the people's life, and where they are here with us, music plays a role that can speak of their mind, speak of their feelings. They will reach a point that the body wouldn't allow to do what they want. And when they reach a point they cannot express themselves, music still can speak for them. They are still able to connect with people. And it is a very personal and inner journey. Through music, it can bring the person to a space that allows them to be who they are. It can bring the person to a place where they feel healthy. That is the power of music. Without doing anything, I just sing for patients. Somehow, from their expression, their bodily reaction, we know that music has brought them to a place where they are comfortable. There are times that are very difficult to express the feelings when we are at the end of life. That's just difficult topics. And music just create a very safe and supportive space for us to talk about life. When a family want to express their love to the patient, they can use music, they can express the thoughts and feelings. It really works both ways. When a person gives or dedicate a song, and a person receives a song, it all creates a meaningful interaction.
How do I describe the theme? Very vibrant. Everyone's very different, but I think everyone has drive to do better and to do more.
I think about the concept of it takes a village to raise a child. I think in a hospice, it basically serves the other end of the spectrum. It takes a village to send someone away.
Whenever anyone of us needs help, our whole team will come out to support.
This team is one team that recognizes the importance of interdisciplinary work. We are not independent professions, and that we need to work together. To be able to do so, you need to be, number one, very confident, know what the patient needs.
We are very good at our own skills. At the same time, we embrace each other's skills and take along each other's skills.
Be aware enough that someone else may be able to help you to achieve your goal much better.
It makes me feel not alone, because sometimes it can be quite isolating. I mean, we check in on one another and I know they got my back.
And which is why this team is so important and so precious.